Okay, cool. Hey, I'm Jan. And yeah, first of all, I'm very happy you are all here for the second year in the Open Source Design Dev Room. Very cool to be and to see so many people interested in design. And yeah, so today I'm going to tell you about getting uni students involved in open source projects, mostly design-wise, or mostly design students, because I did that a few times and I want to pursue it further. Normally I work on OwnCloud. It's like an open source alternative to Dropbox and Google Drive. And normally I would probably be giving a talk about the design process at OwnCloud, but I already did that several times. For example, if you just search YouTube for open source design, Nin's talk, I can recommend. I gave a talk about our open source design process if you're interested in that. That's at the DrupalCon, or if you prefer a shorter version, if you look for OwnCloud Design Wrap, I did a 2-minute wrap on our design process, so that's also very, very educational. So, open source design and uni students. So, first question, are there any university people here? Any people involved with the university? Any professors? Okay, what do you do? Are you professors or lecturers or?
I teach occasionally.
Okay.
Okay.
Who else put their hands up? I really want to hear from everyone. Teaching assistant? Okay. Okay. At design unis or something related to design
or tech?
Okay, computer science. Okay, cool. Okay, so I want to talk to every one of you after this. And because it's a pretty guerrilla operation I've been doing with this. I'm going to show you some examples later, but first of all, I think the simple thing or the simple reason why I'm doing it is because it benefits everyone involved. There's the students, the design students, learning on real projects and not just doing a project for their portfolio, what is usually done. Then there's the professors, which have less work in like mentoring or reviewing because you then do that, or I in my case did that. And then there's the open source projects, which of course have the benefit of work having done for them, whether it be user testing, whether it be design comps, mockups, or anything like that. So I think it's really, it just needs one person to coordinate that, and then it basically benefits everyone involved. So I'm just gonna tell you about what I did so far in that space. So the Hochschule der Medien is the media university in Stuttgart, where I studied myself. And what I did there first is my thesis about usability and free software. And then after I graduated, or during my studies basically, we had this project, the course called Usability Engineering Methods, where you basically learned about the different usability engineering methods, which are card sorting, focus groups, usability testing, stuff like that. I think 10 different methods we had. And you could choose the project that you wanted to work on yourself. So you were assigned a method, I think groups of 2 or 3, and for every method there were 2 groups, I think my group was, we were doing usability testing, so that was quite cool, because I liked that method the most. And then you could choose the project yourself, so most people, like then I think chose MSN or Skype or ICQ or stuff like that, where you basically, with feedback, or the results that you get, the tests that you make, you probably won't forward to the company, or they probably won't care anyway, because they have an in-house agency or someone doing it for them. Or you're not even going to think about forwarding the results to them, because you think that you're just a measly student, and your results are not worth anything. So what I basically did in the year after I graduated, I just mailed my professor and said, hey, can I just come by and present 3 or a few open source projects to the students to pick up and work on? And he said, yeah, sure, you can just come by in the inaugural lecture and just present, and then we'll see. And so I went there and did a quick 10-minute introduction of OwnCloud, what I just told you, Media Goblin, which is an open source Flickr, YouTube, self-hosted thingy, like media hosting, MB Welcome, which is like an open source couchsurfing. Ironically, at the time, it had better, way better design than couchsurfing, even though they improved meanwhile. But I just presented these three open source projects to the students, and I chose these because I was involved in all of the three at the time, or still kind of am. I mean, OwnCloud mostly, but the others, I knew the developers, and I could forward any requests or any feedback, so that was actually valuable. And after I did that, half the groups chose to work on these projects. So two groups on OwnCloud, two on Media Goblin, I think, and one on WeWelcome. And I was really stunned because, it was that simple to just get people working on these projects because they found it interesting, and otherwise they probably would have just chosen Facebook or, I don't know, MySpace or, I don't know, Twitter or whatever, right? One of the groups, for example, was the usability testing group as well, and they chose, or one of the usability testing groups chose OwnCloud, which I found really cool because, as I said, I like usability testing. And at the university, at the Media University, we have a quite cool usability testing lab with separate rooms and cameras and stuff like that. So the students essentially need to do all the things on their own, like they need to recruit the people, they need to organize it, they need to organize the guideline, like how they interview the people, and how normally a usability test is done, like you invite someone, you give them separate tasks, several tasks, and then you watch them perform them, right? And so I didn't need to do anything, which was pretty awesome, because usually that's the most work, and that's usually the reason why you, as a designer for a project, don't do that, because you just simply don't have the time, especially when you're on an open source project and you're the only person working on, or the only designer working on it. So the students do all the busy work, essentially, but the work that they will do anyways and they need to learn. Meanwhile, I sat with the students who do the observing and the protocoling in the other room, and I could also take my own notes and talk to them, and it was really quite interesting to see what comes up in the test, right? I mean, it's like a normal usability test, but you can essentially watch and take your notes, and the students also need to submit a report. That's also additionally cool. But the value is very immediate, right? And requires very little work except just presenting these projects and making students aware. Of course, it depends on the exact course that there is at the university. So, I mean, that university is a technical university, so it's a bit more hands-on. So any normal uni might be different, or a private academy or something. But it depends on the course. So, I can recommend that approach very much. So that was the first time I did that. I think that was 2012. And I definitely want to do that again. But then the year after that, I did a different collaboration with a uni also in Stuttgart, funnily enough, called the Merz Academy, which is a private design academy. Yeah, also in Stuttgart. They mailed me because they saw my work on OwnCloud and asked me if I want to do a 1 week. They have this thing called Pathway Weeks, where each of their three tracks, they have like new media, videography, and I think photography, I'm not quite sure, but one of them is new media. And in the new media track, which is concerned with new media, with interaction design, communication design, they asked me if I would be interested to do a 1 week workshop, essentially, around open source design. So I happily agreed. And there I chose a slightly different format, because at the Media University before, I had like a whole semester, essentially, for that course. So it was slightly different. Like I just needed to mentor the students sometimes. I needed to answer questions and sometimes forward requests or something. And also it was the first time me doing that with the students. So here I did a full 5-day curriculum, essentially. And I chose to focus on OwnCloud for this time. And what I essentially did was there were, I think, 12 students, and I split them up into groups, into four groups, and each of them worked on a different part. So one group worked on sharing, one group worked on the documents app, one group worked on bookmarks, and the fourth group, I actually now forgot, but they also worked on another aspect. I think maybe user management or something. But anyway, they worked on the same product, which was really interesting for everyone because they could also exchange experiences. And then we went from the whole process basically, from either you have an issue, like first we set up the whole system. I taught them how to use GitHub, for example, because they already had experience with HTML, CSS, JavaScript and stuff, so it always depends on the students, of course. But in this case, some even, like two, even had a GitHub account already, so they could help the others. So then we went through the process of like, hey, what is open source design and how is it done? And because I mostly do the open source design work on GitHub, on the issue platform that you prefer. I know GitHub is closed source, but GitLab is basically, I would say, serves the same purpose, as long as it's like, one tracker. I dislike mailing lists for that, but that's a different story. I worked them through the whole process essentially of how it works, of setting up the instance, of finding an issue with the thing you're working on, how you file an issue, how you open it, and then how you communicate, and then how I usually do it, like open an issue with a screenshot or a mock-up or something. And then like two groups also did live mock-ups. Like for example, the people who were working on the bookmarks app, they did a live mock-up in JavaScript and CSS and HTML, of course, for a new interface. Then the sharing group did mockups with a program called Pencil, which is open source, which is a mockup app. Did mockups for a new sharing screen. And that was really cool to get real results together with them. And they directly opened it as issues then. And one important thing, what I also talked about with them, is design resources. So as that was also kind of the intro to get them excited about open source, because in design universities, one of the most interesting thing is always, one of the most interesting things when I studied is like, oh, where are all the font files? Like, where's the Linotype library or something? Where can you download it to your laptop so you can use all the awesome font files, right? That's at least what we did. I don't know about you. Teaching them about open source fonts, for example, was quite exciting because they saw, oh, I can use all these fonts freely and openly for my project. And that was also the base, essentially, for the Open Source Designers Resources repo, or essentially the start of the Open Source Designers GitHub organization. Like, some of these folks are like this dude, and some of these, which have no avatars, are the students from the Merz Academy, and that's basically how the group got started. So that was very important to get these different resources in there. Also, icons, the Noun project, you probably know this icon website, open font library, stuff like that, different websites. If you don't know it, go to github.com/open-source-design and check the resources repository. There's a lot of resources, Creative Commons license photos, typefaces, everything, or also events, or like the Legal Graphics meeting, or the Legal Graphics mag, for example. A lot of exciting things for design students, but open source, essentially. Then, just last year, I was in New Zealand, and I talked to people at two universities, the University of Waikato in the Northern Island, and the Victoria University of Design in Wellington. And I just essentially sent a mail to, I think, an open source mailing list there. And then the Waikato people asked me, hey, are you still around? And I just visited them. And there were like, I don't know, five or seven lecturers And we chatted about how we can bring open source projects together in the curriculum. So yeah, we still need to work on that, or I still need to follow up on that. But the exciting thing was that I basically didn't really need to bring projects from myself, so to say, but rather there's two projects in New Zealand, one called PWIG, which is based, maybe you know it, it's an open source Google Analytics alternative, and Lumio, which is it's like a crowd decision making system. And they're both open source, they're both made in New Zealand, so that's kind of exciting to also just bring together the local projects and universities to work together. So yeah, and that's kind of what I want to continue in, that I want to talk to university people and also to projects, to open source projects which would be interested in working together with universities, which have ideally at least like one person who kind of can manage that. I mean, it's kind of like, it's kind of similar to Google Summer of Code, I guess, but it's more bound to one university. As I said, it's like, from my experience, it's really valuable, really valuable live input that you get and live interaction. So I would be happy to talk to you, and that's it.
Yeah, I mean, in the
Stuttgart University, like in the first university example, it was, I think, third semester, and in the other, it was fifth, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
So
quite early, but that's fine, I think.
Do you think it couldn't work for master's students?
I think so, yeah. I mean, like, I didn't try it out yet with master's students, but I think so too. I mean, of course, you have to adjust it a bit, and just based on their knowledge, but I don't think it would be any different. I mean, I was kind of worried that it wouldn't work for undergrads, because it's like, maybe they need to know programming, or crap, now I need to tell them about GitHub, and maybe they don't know that much about design or about programming, but it would work quite well, so.
And what about remote, online courses? Do you think?
I didn't do that yet. Is Ilio still here? Because I think he does like courses on site for him. That's, maybe that's related. But I never did that. I mean, in the case of the Stuttgart Media University, it was just like, I was there only a few times to mentor them, like, or to talk to them. It was like relaxed mentoring, right? In the case of the Merz Academy, it was 1 week full program. So it was very different. So the first one, or I mean, both would be possible remotely. Actually, depends on the time.
Do you have a sense of how many people stay in the project after class?
That's a really good question, because that's like the thing I've been struggling with most. Really, I mean, that's of course the one of the most important things usually, or like the retention. I would really like that to be more. I mean, it's like for each of the programs, it was probably like one person or something. I mean, max, right? That's the thing. Like, for the first thing, I didn't have any expectations, but already having the usability test done, basically, like if it would have been just one group working on it, right, that would have been already super valuable, and it was valuable, right? And it would have been cool if more people would have stuck around, but I think the one-time thing is also super valuable in this case.
One quick question. maybe you said it, I didn't hear, but how did you get in touch with the university initially with the suggestion of open source projects? Was it you chose for your dissertation, or was it somebody said, here's a thing?
For the university where I studied, I chose my dissertation topic, and my professor knew like that I was into open source, and then I just asked him with that proposal, and then they said, yeah, sure, do it. So I approached them, and yeah, in the second case, they heard about my work on cloud, and they were interested in that. And
so if you were going to approach a university that might not necessarily know about open source, and you, and they had a similar thing where students had to do an audit or a heuristic evaluation or something of a piece of software, if you wanted to suggest open source software.
I think that's that would work, because oftentimes the universities also collaborate with companies, right? And then essentially, instead of the company, it's just an open source project. The important thing is that there needs to be this one person, ideally, who knows about the project or really is involved, who can serve as kind of a person who can talk about it, right? Because then it might as well be a company then, really. And then I don't see any problem with it. Depends on the university, of course, if they usually do that. But I mean, I've so far only experienced a very relaxed atmosphere regarding that, or even being very excited about it, specifically involving open source or open source projects. Any more questions? No? Cool. You can also talk to me anytime, or find me on Twitter, GitHub, or.